Hello from Dio. For this video, I'm going to talk about the methods of placing the DIOnavi guide safely. Here are the steps to take before placing the guide. Step number one is checking the guide. Before the surgery, you must always check the guide for the following checkpoints. First, you must check the clinic name. Make sure the clinic name on the guide is referring to the clinic the guide was sent to. Next, you must check the patient's name. The patient's name on the guide should match the name of the patient who's going to receive the surgery. Next, check if the implant placement location is correct for the patient. There may be someone with the same name with a different surgery point, so checking every step is important. Finally, check the inner and outer side of the guide to see if there are any problems. By checking the guide in advance, surgery can be predicted and mistakes can be prevented. When checking the inner part of the guide, extrusions like these between number 43 and 44 can be found. These extrusions were grooves in the scanned teeth, which then became extrusions in the guide. Since the guide may not be properly seated due to this, make sure to check the guide and delete these extrusions if found. This is a different case for a different patient. If the patient has a wide gap between their teeth, when the guide is produced, the gap becomes extrusions aligning to that space. This may hinder the fit of the guide, so it is necessary to delete the extrusions before seating it. Now that we have checked the guide, the next step is to seat the guide on the teeth. It is extremely important to seat the guide accurately. You must first visually check with naked eye if the guide is seated properly on the teeth surface through the guide windows and check if there is movement. If there is a rocking motion or a gap in the guide window between the guide and the teeth, delete the inner part of the guide. This kind of misfit can happen to stone impression or scanning errors. After checking the fit with the naked eye, the next step is to take the CT with the guide seated. But there are some precautions when taking a CT. There may be an error because of the guide, but there also may be an error because of how the CT is taken. Here are some tips to prevent movement of the guide. Number one, take the CT scan after accurately placing the guide on the patient's oral cavity. Number two, position the patient's jaw stably to prevent any movements during scanning. Number three, it is important to place the patient in a stable and comfortable position to reduce movement. And here are some tips on how to increase stability. For partial guides, place a cotton roll on the anterior molar and use a bite block to prevent movements. For full arch guides, place a cotton roll on both sides of the molar. Do not use a bite block for this case. After the CT is taken with the guide in place, check if the position and direction of the sleeve in the CT image and planned image are the same. And also, check the offset value in the planned CT and see if the offset value is same in the CT with the guide. Here is an example. Implant location is planned in the first CT, guide location and height is planned in the second CT, and CT taken with the actual guide is in place for the third CT. You can see that the offset is 11.3 for that, but the actual planned offset was 10.5, which means the guide is not accurately seated on the teeth. For the next step, You have to look more closely at the CT and check the merging line in it. You can see here in these photos that there are noticeable gaps between the guide and the bone. This means the guide is not fully seated. In conclusion, it is very important to have the guide correctly and accurately seated. If the surgery is conducted without an accurately seated guide, the guide will not be seated on the planned direction and it may cause problems. If there's a slight difference, correct the guide by deleting the inner part. But if the cancellation does not help the accurate seating, it is best that you ask for a different guide. Now we know how to check and seat the guide. We will now find out how to store and sterilize the guide. Because the guide is made of hardened resin, hot temperatures should be avoided because it may cause disfigurement. So it is best to store in cool places. Just before seating the guide in the patient's oral cavity before surgery, we must sterilize the guide. This can be done during the time when the patient is getting anesthesia for about 20 minutes. Mix the chlorhexidine and alcohol at the ratio of 9 to 1 as the sterilizing solution. And rinse it with saline just before seating in the patient's mouth. This is all, guys. I have told you the steps you must take before placing the guide. Thank you for listening. This was Dio.